Flowers can brighten your day, but there are a lot of hidden meanings behind their beauty. For more on this, let's welcome author and flower expert Cheralyn Darcey.
Yay!
Cheralyn, thank you so much for joining us this morning. I didn't know there were so many hidden meanings behind flowers.
There are. There's meanings behind every single flower and plant. In fact, the meanings are the same in the plant, the berries, the fruit, as there are in the flowers. It's just that we've forgotten them, that's all.
You've got some examples. Take us. This looks divine.
Well, these are all available in your garden or florist at the moment, and they're very popular for Christmas. Mm-hmm. So what we've got here is dahlias. These are actually the national flower of Mexico.
Have we got peonies?
Oh, we've got peonies right here, and these are in season at the moment.
So I just wanted to know how to pronounce that.
Peonies. Or some people say peonies, yeah.
And dahlias are very beautiful. What sort of hidden meanings do they carry?
Dahlias mean you can do it. Encouragement, achievement. Oh. If you want to wish someone success as well, they're very good. And at the end of the year when people are going through exams or finishing up, things are a great flower to give to people.
And in terms then, how do you know what they mean though?
Okay, I research all these things. I'm a botanical researcher and explorer, and I look back at all of the uses through time and through different cultures, herbal medicine, and also through the Victorian language of flowers as well. They were really good at putting all these things together and documenting them.
Now, peonies that we mentioned at the start, they are so stunning.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
I would just adore to get a bunch of these, but what do they mean?
They mean I wish you well, and it means in health but also in prosperity. So they're another one of those success flowers, and they're a great one to give to somebody if they're feeling a bit down or feeling a bit ill as well. And because, as you said, they just make us feel good. And you can look at the way they present. They're very soft and fluffy and pink, a very healing colour, through to their burgundies as well.
So give that to someone in hospital.
Absolutely.
What about quicksand roses? Which one are those?
Look, these are a florist rose and they're becoming incredibly popular. They're around right at the moment and they're popular for Australian weddings. They're a very sandy coloured rose and they're a hybrid tea rose. And they mean make a wish. So a really good Christmas rose as well. Very faint scent, but a beautiful rose. And they also connect with dreams, desires and innocence. A bridal rose and a lovely Christmas rose as well, a soft one.
Now tell us about the Christmas bush. Okay.
Most states have a plant that they connect with Christmas. We don't have all the Northern Hemisphere plants like holly and mistletoe here. So in colonial times, the colonialists would look for plants that were familiar and looked a little bit like Northern Hemisphere plants. These aren't actually the flowers. These are the sepals. So the flowers come
They're
the sepals. They're the little...
What's a sepal?
They're the little tiny leaves that surround the flower. So in springtime, your Christmas bush, this is New South Wales Christmas bush, will have little white flowers. Coming up to Christmas, the little sepals, the little, these will start to go brilliant red. These are still a little bit soft, but they go bright red. So you can see why in colonial times they would think, oh, these are a great Christmas
present. So they look like little Santas.
They do look little Santas,
And what do they mean?
Oh, they mean happiness. They mean joy and success as well, and energy and change. So the end of the year as
You associate them very much with Christmas, though, don't you?
You do. Yeah, particularly in the eastern states, but they're getting more popular across Australia as well.
And now what about these quite sort of sweet-looking things? Are they edible berries?
No. Well, the whole plant, and don't do this at home, go and see a herbalist, the whole plant is actually St John's wort, and we call it...
You can use that to get rid of evil...
Yes.
Evil spirits?
Look, there's so many things associated with St John's wort. They're called hypericum berries, and hypericum is the Latin name. Very much associated with Christmas, but a cure-all. And they're a painkiller, a sedative as well. When
Give
you go to a herbalist...
I've got another 3 hours of this.
But King George the Sixth, he loved these so much that he named his favourite racehorse Hypericum in the honour of because it gave him so much relief as well.
So these mean do not fear.
Do not fear, protection, longevity, and also they do mean get well as well. But do not fear. So
if someone was going into a scary experience, like an operation,
these would be great.
That,
you could put those and peonies together. You'd have a really great bunch. Yeah, it'd be get well, don't fear. You're going be okay.
And what about poinsettias? I mean, great combination, red and green. And these are very much a Christmas flower.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, you know what? They're actually, they are, because we make them that way. Yeah. But they don't, they're actually a winter flowering plant. The red that you can see, they're called bracts, which are modified leaves. And if you look in the centre, you can see the flowers. Yeah. They're there. Mm. So they're protecting the flowers.
Do they have a meaning?
They do have a meaning. They mean thank you, appreciation and success. Really good present to give to people. And after Christmas, after you've had them in the pot plants, you can put them into your garden. But they look like that at winter time in Australia.
They do too. Yeah. And it's really nice because in winter they're the one splodge of colour that you actually have in your garden.
Absolutely. Yeah. And because they need about 12 hours of darkness in order to go red like that. So
that's a bit like Jono.
I was just reading your book.
Yes.
And I love this one for resistance, St. Barnaby's Thistle. That's interesting after the election result on the weekend.
Yes, absolutely. The language of flowers connects with everything.
And Cheralyn's book, it is absolutely fabulous, has details on 1,000 flowers and it's called Flowerpedia. And everyone in our studio audience, you are going home with a copy. Thank you so much to Rock for publishing.
Yay! Big great Christmas present too.
That's so fascinating. And thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
It's much appreciated.